Hello, photography students. I am going to go over how to create a selective color photograph, which means the photograph is in black and white except for one spot of color, one area you decide to put in color. This is called Selective Color Project, and it's located in week 3 of second semester. This is what your final image should look like. I'm going to go through all these steps on how to create an image like this in Pixlr. Okay, so let's go ahead and go to Pixlr.com, open up the editor, and you're going to open up your image that you created for this project. Great pictures for this project are ones that you plan out ahead of time. Something that will look really good with just a highlighted, focused area of color. A lot of times people will use portraits for this. That's a great idea for this project. You can put the eyes and the lips or just the lips in color. I'm going to use a different example. You can do just about anything like this, plan it out, and come up with a great idea. I've already opened up an image. I'm going to use this one, actually, for this project. Okay, so you start with your color image. If you want to play around with the color, you might want to adjust it, like I always do with the saturation. I've already played with it a little bit to make my colors pop. The more colorful, the better, because you want it to really stand out, the object that you're going to create in color. Okay, so I start with my original photo, and immediately I'm going to duplicate this layer. So what I want is two of the exact same photo, one on top of each other. So I'm going to go to layer, duplicate layer, duplicate layer. And if I check my layers menu, I can see that here I am on my copy, and my background is exactly the same. All right, so I'm going to play around with the copy, the top layer right now. So make sure you have that one selected. I'm going to remove the color. So removing the color is going to adjustment and desaturate. And immediately I have a black and white photo. You may want to adjust it. Sometimes the values are a little bit different when you're looking in color to black and white. I'm going to adjust this just a little bit with upping the contrast a little bit, just a little bit more for the effect I want. So adjust it accordingly. Right about here is good. Okay. So now I'm ready for the next step, which is to create an area of color. So what I have is a color image and a black and white image on top of that. These are my two layers. And if I want to check that, I just uncheck my top layer to double, yep, it's still in color underneath there. So then I make that visible again. Checking this box makes it visible or invisible. All right, so I'm going to zoom in so that I can carefully erase just this wine bottle I want to be in color. So I'm going to zoom in. Few times, get in there real close. You need to work really carefully. It looks really good if you do this. If you accidentally erase over what you're trying to do, it looks terrible. So you want to be really careful. One of my first tricks I'm going to use to select this area and erase most of it is I'm going to use my selection tools over here. I'm going to use the magic wand, which will select most of this bottle. And you can see I have some edges here that I'll be able to erase, but not over here because this value is too close. So I'm going to grab my eraser and erase some of the easy edges. Choose an eraser that works for you. I'm going to use kind of a larger one to get the most of it quickly erased. Okay, so as I erase through, you can't see very much right at first because this is a dark bottle, but you can start to see up here there's a purple area. So while I have it selected, I can be sloppy on this edge right here, because that's up here. I can also do the bottle cap. You'll start to see the red show up. All of this, I'm gonna come back in here after I deselect and do a better job, more careful. Okay, you can see where I'm erasing. Here. So I'm gonna try to get the bulk of it, and then I will come back in and clean up what I didn't catch the first time with the selection. Okay, can't really see too much yet, so now I'm going to deselect, and if I want to, I can zoom in even more to get more careful. You can see you're going to be real careful right in here. I'm going to grab my eraser again. I probably want to make this a little bit smaller pretty soon. This is a big chunk. But I'm using this hard edge. You can use different shapes eraser. This works pretty well for what I'm trying to do because I have a hard line that I'm erasing. next to might not work for what you're erasing. If you're doing lips or eyes or something like that, you're probably going to want to use the round brush. Okay, and get the label right here. This is kind of a dark bottle, so not a lot of color, but I'm going to be real careful right here and try to get a good line. If you make a mistake, just back up. You go to edit, undo. I think that's primarily in color. Okay, I think it's probably done. I'll double check. Yep, and then I'll zoom out and can go to view, show all. And there you go. There's my final image. So I have a black and white image with selected color, meaning just this bottle is in color. All right, so save your image and turn it in.